Ollie's claims to have good stuff cheap, but is everything that good? Greetings and welcome back to another cookie-tastic episode of the Vodkast. I am your host, as always, Geycen Oliveira. With us today is Caco. I'm going to go with Caco just because it's funnier. Caco, Oreo. We're going to have the Oreo Caco heads off today. We're going to find out if Caco is worth the All right, hang on a second here. I've got a confession to make. I already recorded this whole video once, and sadly, my mouse is something wrong with it. It keeps double-clicking, so when I actually hit record, I actually hit record and then stop. So this isn't the best example of what I was going to show you. Anywho, I don't have a lot of faith in these being any good because they're 99-cent clearance cookies. They just happen to fall. You know, it's almost like they came from a distant, not so distant, you know, galaxy. It's like our worlds like kind of dipped into each other in this thin place in between. And for some reason, you know, a whole pallet of these ended up on washed up on shore and... Well, Ollie's picked them up and sold them for 99 cents, and we're going to find out if they're any good today. What do you say? I discovered the Caco cookies when I was at Ollie's the other day. They had sent me the Christmas flyer, and they had a Trapper Wolf Star Wars X-Wing helmet, and I was super excited about it, so I went and I got that. And whilst I was there, I discovered that it appears that Ollie's is making their own little mini Oreo knockoffs called Cacos or Cacos. I'm not sure exactly what they call them. I'm going with the Caco. They're a chocolate sandwich cookie. And the only reason why I say I believe these are made by Ollie's is due to the fact of the artwork here. Okay, so we're looking at Bud's Best Cookies. Bud is apparently their mascot, whereas, you know, Oreo doesn't really need a mascot. They are their own mascot. And if we compare Ollie himself with Bud, and let's take a look at the guy from Building 19 as well. I'm not sure if his name. Do you know his name? What's the name? I'm sure we can figure it out. Anywho, if you look at the art style, the way the stores are displayed and everything's laid out, they're pretty much the same store. I imagine that they're either brother, sister, uncle, cousin, you know, twice removed. They're all part of a conglomerate, maybe, or whatever they call that in the retail business. Anywho, let's start with the Oreo cookie. We're gonna skip the smell test because I think we all know what an Oreo smells like, or a bag at least of Oreo smells like. Maybe not. I don't know. Maybe I'm one of the rare few that just love... God damn it. All of these cookies that I'm putting my hands on, they're missing half. Like, they're broken in half. I want a good representation. There we go. It's creaming out the side a little bit, but it's not too bad. I would say, generally speaking, I look like a snake, but my upper half is all human. No, I would say that there is definitely more girth to the cookie on the Caco, whereas the Oreo is trying to stick to basically a... they're trying to take the formula of a large Oreo and get it down there so that when you eat this, it's not like you're eating too much of one or the other. But needless to say, it's a tiny little cookie, so to get that ratio right is impressive. So let's just remind ourselves what an Oreo tastes like. That's a real good time. I like little Oreos because it feels like you're, you know, what's the serving size here? 9 cookies is 140 calories. That's not bad. I don't know what the regular Oreos are. I should know that information. But nonetheless, like, you can eat a few of these and not feel like you're, you know, pigging out or whatever. Now let's try the Caco. See if they're any good. What do you say? And just like before, these things are amazing. They're really good. They stand toe-to-toe, head-to-head with Oreo in every sense of the way. Now, the difference between them is this. The cookies on these have a weird, tiny little aftertaste. It doesn't last long. It's gone before you know it. And you're back in the box for another one. These are the standard, the staples. These could easily just, you know, come along. You might be at a party and not even notice what you're eating. The cream in these are definitely a little bit sweeter, which isn't a bad thing. If I had to score each of them, I would give them both a 9. They're both equally as good. Wait a minute. If they're equally as good, they must be amazing together. Let's try that, huh? That sounds pretty crazy, doesn't it? Woo, we are really tempting the fates here. Get Mondelez online, because that's magic happening right there. Somehow, two cookies that taste very similar, but just different enough that when you combine them, they pull themselves apart in your mouth and have a little party. And over here, they're doing a little sweet dance. Over here, they're doing a little savory cookie dance. It's amazing. If you have an Ollie's or a Building 19, you should check out and see if you can find Bud's Best Caco Cookies. I think they're a delight. And they definitely go toe-to-toe with the Oreo here. I'm really impressed. I did not expect a lot from these when I found them for 99 cents. So if you find yourself in an Ollie's or Building 19 and you like Oreos, you should definitely try them out. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you guys are loving the content that I'm creating as much as I love creating the content that you guys are watching, please consider liking, commenting, subscribing, sharing, and hitting the little bell icon, because it'll let you know every time I put out a new video. Don't forget to make somebody smile today and make yourself a better person tomorrow than you were today. Tomorrow, let's make the world spin a little bit happier and a little bit nuttier. Together, let's sing and dance in the sun and the rain as one, my brothers and sisters. Live life to the fullest and love every moment, because you just never know when that last moment's going to come for you. However, never live in fear of that moment. Always live in love and never let your inner child die. Oh, Lord. Take care of yourselves, take care of one another, and take care of those around you who cannot take care of themselves, for they are the ones that need it the most. And if no one has told you today that they love you, the Vodkast loves you very much, just the way you are. All right, guys, do no harm. I'm Geycen Oliveira. This is the Vodkast, and I'll catch you guys a little bit further on down the road. Take care, everybody.
Don't go to sleep with a catch it in your pocket.